In this video lecture, we will understand working of steam turbine. This is our laboratory setup and it is actual systems of steam turbine, boilers, steam supply, and everything is in working condition. But due to Boiler Regulation Act, the boiler service is terminated, and so we cannot run this turbine. But we can understand the exact component and exact system of the steam turbine. First, we know that steam turbine is working on the Rankine cycle. Steam power plant is working on the Rankine cycle. Here is the temperature entropy diagram of the power plant. Here from 1 to 2 pumping will take place. At higher pressure, water is supplied to the boiler. And from 3A to 3B, latent heat of evaporation will be absorbed. 3B, this water will be converted into saturated vapor, and then superheating takes place, and up to 0.3 steam will be superheated, and then 3 to 4 this is the expansion process. Here we have shown the ideal process, so isentropic expansion is shown. In real practice, it is not possible isentropic expansion due to some many reasons. The point 4 is depend on the arrangement. Why this diagram is shown here? This 4 point may be at any place, maybe saturated point or maybe cooling after the condensation point. Or pressure of this condensation process may be variable. Suppose condenser, it is supplying in condenser, then the pressure is maybe less than the atmospheric pressure. Why? Because maximum expansion takes place, P2 is the higher pressure and P1 is the lower pressure, then maximum work done will be available. So suppose it is condensing type turbine, then pressure is less than atmospheric, and suppose it is the discharging type turbine, then it is discharged at some higher temperature, higher pressure. It is slightly more than the atmospheric pressure. So this steam, exhaust steam, is used for some process industry, and the heat of this turbine is utilized. So in this case, condensation not takes place. So we have to keep in mind that the exhaust pressure may be variable as per discharge type turbine or exhaust type turbine, or it may be condensing type turbine. So in our case, this turbine is exhaust type turbine and the steam will be discharged in draft tube. So draft tube is provided, then the pressure of the turbine is higher. We have seen here, this pipe is coming from boiler and it is insulated. Here asbestos lining is done. So boiler house to turbine supply, we can prevent the heat loss by providing insulation. This is valve. This valve is open or closed manually, and we can lock this valve. When we want some repairing or maintenance, then this valve will be operated. So after closing the valve, we can lock this valve and then we can do our maintenance work. So here you can see we have locked this valve. This is main valve, and then this, after this valve, this band is connected with the throttling system of the turbine. Here it is turbine, this steam will be supplied to the nozzle, and its supply, its quantity may be governed by this throttling system, and this throttling system is connected with the governor. So here supply quantity, supply pressure, or the parameter of the steam is not changed by manual operation. It is totally controlled by the governor. This is governing mechanism. This bar is connected with the nozzle. So nozzle throttle area can be changed by reciprocating mechanism of this bar. This is spring-loaded control valve. If the speed is increased, then what we have to require? We have to require less amount of the steam is required to control the speed. So at that time, this bar will be going inside and throttle area will be reduced. When speed reduction due to higher load connected, then the RPM will be reduced and this bar will be come out, and then throttle area will be increased. This is turbine wheel, turbine blade. Half portion of the casing is removed. Similar way, it is connected here by gasket, and the other half portion is the casing of the turbine. This is the wheel, single wheel turbine. If you have read this manual of this turbine, then it is mentioned that this is velocity compounded turbine. Why compounding is required? Because the jet of the water, the jet of the steam is creating high velocity, high kinetic energy available in, suppose we are expanding in single nozzle. So this jet create revolution of the turbine up to 30,000 RPM. And this is the higher limit, 10 times higher limit as per requirement of the generator RPM. We can run generator maximum up to 3000 RPM. This is depend on the number of poles of the generator. You can decide the RPM of the generator as per winding pole. And this is possible, suppose two pole generator is there, then maximum RPM is 3000 possible. So we have to reduce 1/10 of the RPM required to reduce 10 times. So it is required big gear. So in this case, the compounding is provided. It may be pressure compounding, velocity compounding, or it is a mixed type compounding turbine. This is velocity compounding turbine. But one question may be rise in your mind. That is, this is single wheel. You studied the number of stages is available for compounding of the turbine. But here the wheel is single, so we can say it is a single stage turbine. But here jet is provided center of this blade. This is the blade, number of blade, and jet is provided here in tangential direction. And this jet is come out on both side and create here swirling. It is create helical path. Here some reversing chamber is available. This is reversing chamber, periphery of the reversing chamber. So jet coming outside of the blade is returned back to other blade. Here you can see the helix is created entire wheel one by one. So jet is not created on single nozzle. This velocity is reduced gradually in with the help of reversing chamber. This nozzle is not expanding 100% steam into this nozzle. Nozzle is provided here bottom. We can see here we have provided single nozzle, but jet is created here. No steam exit is coming here. This part like pipe is connected outside with the throttling mechanism, and this is part of the reversing chamber. This two bars, this is separating. Some minimum gap is possible here, wheel and this component. So here reversing chamber is returning the jet. Jet is not going inside. Once the jet is applied, this jet coming by some helical path. So entire wheel periphery, this is create a helical path like screw, and gradually the velocity will be reduced. So that's why that is known as velocity compounded turbine. Here entry will takes place tangentially, not radially. Entry takes place tangentially. So this is tangential flow velocity compounded turbine. This is bearing, oil cooled bearing, and this is coupling. We can couple here generator or any mechanism, whatever we are interested to rotate. Hydraulic type dynamometer. A dynamometer to measure how many power is generated. So same way in IC engine, we have applied belt type dynamometer. We have applied load on the belt end and we have measured the power. Similar way, we will generate here some load and we will measure the power generation. Because we have not connected here generator. Otherwise, all steam turbines are used for power generation and generator is coupled. But this is our laboratory setup, so we have connected here hydraulic governor, hydraulic dynamometer. We will discuss in later stage the working of the governor, how it working. This is arm connected with the dynamometer. Here spirit level is provided. Here above indicator dial is available and here we can apply mass. This arm can move up and down. So depends on movement and balance weight applied here, we can calculate the torque generated on the wheel. This arm to the center of the shaft is the arm length is given. So we can calculate the load, whatever may be force available at this arm length. So we can calculate Newton into meter. Maybe torque may be calculated into Newton into meter and we can find the power from revolution of the turbine. Some adjustment are provided to maintain the arm horizontally. This is a pipe supplying water to the dynamometer. You studied hydraulic coupling in hydraulic machines. This hydraulic coupling type dynamometer is there. Hydraulic coupling is working on the principle of one rotor is working as a pump and other rotor is working as a turbine and both casing are connected. So pump supply high jet into turbine and turbine is rotated. Both are connected nearby. So in this purpose we have required water supply to pump. So this pipeline is for supply of the water. Inlet will be go to the blade of the pump and exit of the turbine will be coming out. Here turbine means not turbine our steam turbine. It is turbine of the dynamometer, hydraulic coupling type dynamometer. Here arm should be remain horizontal, so that's why here spirit level is provided and the movement can be adjusted by some mechanism. So here it is not very important to how it is working, but here our purpose of this video lecture is the understanding the working of the steam turbine. Here this is bearing I have shown in earlier stage and this is glands. Here glands is provided. This is connecting directly with the casing. Here inside carbon glands are provided and it is in the portion of 3 segment. So steam from the inside cannot leakage outside. Otherwise, here rotating mechanism, some clearance is present. So, steam can take leakage with high velocity because the high pressure and velocity is present inside the chamber. So, this leakage is completely prevented by carbon glands. So first carbon glands and then bearing is provided. And this bearing is oil cooled bearing because due to the high temperature of the steam, the bearing and entire body is at high temperature. This is the oil pouring area and oil cooling pipeline. These pipes is oil supply pipeline. Cold oil coming from cooler. Oil cooler is there. Cold oil from oil cooler coming inside bearing. It is rotating inside the bearing and hot oil coming outside. And it is going to the oil cooler. This pipeline is functioning for oil circulation. And this is the indicate the oil level. Suppose oil supply is stopped, not supplying, then we can see here the oil level. So in other side, this is not available, this oil gauge. Here oil gauge is not available, but it is both side, two bearings are supply with oil cooling and oil circulating system. Here one more tube is available. This tube is commonly connected after. Why this tube is provided? This tube is connected again, and single is going outside. This tube is connected exact outside of the glands. Why it is connected at the exit of the glands? It is exit connected exit of the glands. Support turbine is exhaust type turbine, then pressure will be higher inside the chamber. Minimum pressure will be higher as compared to atmospheric pressure. So minor steam leakage always takes place from glands. I have mentioned we can eliminate leakage of the steam from the glands, but it is not possible because due to the continuous contact of carbon glands, it may be worn out and some portion, some proportion it will be leakage. So suppose exhaust type turbine, then the steam is coming out from glands and this steam coming outside and it will be condensed because the outside temperature is low. So this condensed steam will be discharged outside. Otherwise, what happened? It is spreading outside the region. So, this will be collected and discharged outside. Suppose turbine is condensing type turbine. If condensing type turbine, then there is a chance of the air leakage inside because the air pressure will be going lower than atmospheric. At that time, air may be entered from this gland. And we should prevent air inside the entry of the air inside the chamber because air will be go to the condenser and it will prevent heat transfer and handling of the air and the steam is difficult. So at that time this tube is used for supplying steam. Here steam will be supplied to glands and steam going through gland leakage into internal portion of the turbine. So here we can prevent air leakage. Pipe is already supplying steam, so air cannot enter inside the turbine. So here dual type of function. Maybe the requirement of the turbine is exhaust type, then condensate will be collected, and suppose turbine is the condensing type, then we will supply steam to prevent air leakage. It should be clear the purpose of this connection. This is draft tube. The exhaust steam will be discharged from this draft tube, and here some internal arrangement is provided. So it may be exhausted outside the laboratory. This is draft tube. So we may use this turbine as an exhaust type turbine. This is internally going outside. Condensate will be going outside. This is other side bearing. This is also a gland. And after this bearing, this side governor is provided. So this is governor. Centrifugal type governor. Okay, so this is centrifugal governor. I have shown from other side. This is spring loaded and clamped with fixed body. And this lever or this bar is connected inside with flying mass. The governor is a centrifugal type governor. So inside this body, some mass is rotating radially outside or inside, depends on the RPM. So when this is expand radially, then this sleeve will, this bar will come out. And always it is controlled by the spring. Normally it is not in normal RPM, it is not expand. But if certain RPM increase beyond the limit, then this mass will expand and this spring will be going to tension. And this round bar, this valve, this sleeve or round bar is coming outside. And it is working like a rocker. Here it is pivoted. Okay, here it is pivoted. So when this coming outside, this bar, this rocker arm, this working as a rocker arm is moving on top backside, our backside. This is coming our side. And due to the pivot here, it is going to other side. So during starting, I have shown other control for throttling. I have mentioned that the throttling area will be changed by this. Here this bar. So this bar coming out and this bar going inside, and going inside, that's why that is controlling the throttling area, reducing throttling area, so spin supply will be reduced. This is basic governor working to change in RPM within some limit. Suppose generator is set up for 3000 RPM, then it control approximately 3050 RPM or below 50 RPM. But suppose 3000 to 60,000 double RPM is changed, then here emergency governor is provided. So here two types of governor available. This is the primary governor control for lower range. This is part of the emergency governor. This is again connected inside the governing mechanism. This mechanism is closed and this is internal one component is provided. I am showing you by other diagram. And this is a lever rotating on this pivot point. This is move on either direction. And here one bar is connected with this spring. This spring is locked here in one slot. So when that is moving outside, left side or right side, it is rotating clockwise, then this bar will be going with this lever. And this spring will be removed from the slot. The spring is rotated and it is torsionally locked. When this spring end is, here one spring is provided, this spring end is removed from here, the entire mechanism will be rotated. So torsion type spring end, when it is locked with torsion, and if you release this end, then what happens? This is rotated. So this rotated, this bar, this spring is rotated on vertical axis. Inside, some valve is provided. So this valve will close steam supply 100% and turbine will be stopped. Steam will be stopped and turbine will be ultimately stopped. So this is secondary governor and it is an emergency governor. Now you can see the spring. Here it is locked by torsion, but when you can remove here and you lift the upward, then this will be rotated. But here this bar should move upward. This is now stopping this lever and this spring. But when this is moving upside, this is removed totally here, then this shaft will be rotated due to the release of the torsion of the spring. See, I am trying to remove this bar. This is rotated fully. Right now it is loose. This is mechanism inside. I have shown one lever. I have shown it is rotated clockwise or anticlockwise, and one round bar is connected with spring. We have seen this externally. This spring is locked here and bottom one lever is locked. This is internal part. We have seen only external. You can see here. This lever is connected with butterfly valve. I have shown this is rotated clockwise or anticlockwise, not fully, but it is rotating pivoted. But internally, this part is connected with butterfly lever. So I am going to show this with diagram how internally it is working. This is connected with butterfly lever. This pin. This is internal part. We can see only this portion only. And this is internally connected with shaft of the turbine. It is a parallel, it is near to governor. And here this wing is fixed in the disc. Here one disc is rotating with this shaft. And this butterfly wing type pivoted on this screw. So आप ये spring से connect नहीं रखोगे तो it will be rotated outside. क्योंकि कोई भी disc में आप mass है balance नहीं रखेंगे तो ज्यादा mass है वो externally outside it will rotate. So here it is spring loaded covered. But when RPM is increased maximum, then what happens? At this pivot point, this screw is the pivot point, this part going outside due to mass of the centrifugal force, due to centrifugal force of mass of this wing. So when it is going outside, this pin will be moved anticlockwise at this pin point. is going anti-clockwise because it is also on the this smaller shaft. And this external lever, I have shown this lever externally, this is going also anti-clockwise because both are in same shaft. So when it is going outside anti-clockwise, this bar will be pulled towards upside and it is removing this spring from lock position. It is also removing lock pin and here bottom one lever is provided. I have shown clearly. I have moved by some movement by my finger in later stage. So this is removing lock of the spring and due to the torsion of the spring, this shaft will be rotated. In normal condition, this disc, this is similar to the throttle body of the carburetor. So this disc always remain parallel. So flow can take place easily. But when emergency governor is operated, this disc coming to perpendicular direction. So we can reduce totally, we can totally stop the steam flow. So this is a one disc is nearly diameter of the this pipe. So emergency governor operate beyond some emergency RPM. When it operate, it will stop completely the steam supply. And when RPM is reduced or steam turbine is stopped, it cannot operate or cannot reset automatically. We have to reset because here this pin and this spring is rotated. So we have to set manually. We can identify that here emergency control governor was operated due to the crossing limit of the turbine RPM. So this diagram is provided by company, but we have not scanned earlier stage, so it is not exact darkness is available, but this pin and this mechanism is inside the and near the governor position. We have applied this casing. First stage we have seen without casing, some emergency exit of the steam is provided. This is coupling, hydraulic coupling. How it working? We are discussing on next stage. Coupling, hydraulic coupling. So this is the diagram of the hydraulic coupling. Here two impeller connected face by face. This is input shaft. So here I have shown hydraulic coupling. The input shaft is coming from turbine and this is output shaft, but both shaft are not coupled here. Some gap is available. One end is provided impeller of the pump. So what is doing pump impeller? Pump impeller is creating flow. You have to apply or in supply inlet water. Some inlet is required to provide this pump impeller. And turbine impeller, what is doing turbine impeller? Turbine impeller is absorbing high velocity jet of water. Suppose here we are considering water turbine. So high jet of water is absorbing by turbine impeller and it is creating rotation. So here pump will create jet of water and this jet of water directed to the impeller of the turbine. And impeller of the turbine is connected with this casing. So this will rotate, depends on jet supply by water. Suppose jet is not enough, then this will not rotate. But when jet is supply is high amount of velocity, then this casing will be rotated. Now what we will do, this casing is connected by one arm. This arm have and some mass provision and spirit level was provided. And this arm is provided with mass at end, so it is preventing rotation. But suppose force is increased, then this arm will be lifted. So that is calibrated in Newton meter scale, so we can measure how the torque is generated. If enough torque is not generated, this will slip. This coupling will be slip, so it cannot rotate the turbine runner. So this hydraulic coupling is the part of your theory subject, but here it is a realistic coupling. This coupling is used, so outside you cannot see the inside turbine at this impellers. So that's why we have supplied cold water. I have shown earlier stage the two pipes. One water supply coming from overhead tank to this impeller. It is entry is provided on impeller and exit of this turbine is going to again discharge. So two smaller diameter pipe coming from ground and it is connected with this dynamometer coupling. See, this pipe is coming from source and it is directly going to this casing. This is casing of this hydraulic coupling. Here inside two rotor is present. One rotor or runner or impeller. That's why this pipe is provided, otherwise not necessary. This is emergency exit valve. Steam can leakage from this valve. And this is eye bolt to lift the entire turbine mechanism. Here we have provided one nozzle exit only. We have seen the governor and throttling mechanism is only one. But bottom of this casing, there are larger bolt are. This plug is provided. 1, 2 and 3 is visible. So, suppose we are want to increase the power supply, then we can apply more throttling mechanism here. We can remove this bolt plug and we can introduce here entry of the steam, which given in, this is laboratory setup, so only one nozzle is given. But we can enter many nozzles and we can apply large quantity of steam to increase the power supply. So this bolt is provided for increase the capacity. You can see here only one nozzle is connected. Here one nozzle connected, 2, 3, 4 other you can connect here. This is foundation. Okay, so one side governing mechanism, emergency governing mechanism, and other side mechanical coupling, and then other hydraulic coupling.